Howdy, howdy, howdy. I'm glad to be here. Hope you are too. And want to talk to you about what not to name your business. And one of the things that drives me nuts, and even though I probably 10 years ago would have been all for it because I thought, oh, that's a good play on words. But this whole idea, and I see a lot of vendors do this, you know, when they're first setting up their name and their branding, are going to start their branding, they use a name that has some kind of dog meaning, or they use their logo of a dog, and it's a real dog. And the problem with that is it doesn't always tell what you're selling. Now, if you're selling dog food, then it's okay, or dog collars, but not hot dogs. And you could have a bad inference of people, food, and dog, you know, icons and logos. So you may want to rethink that in if you've already done it and you're already branded good and people know, okay. But there's a place in a town near me that's called Wolf Street Bistro or Wolf Street something, and it doesn't have they serve hot dogs, okay? And that's their play on words. Instead of it being, you know, hot dog street food or hot dog street bistro or whatever, it's Wolf Street, and it's wolf like you, a dog barking, and they have a dog on the side of their food trailer, and they literally are parked outside of a dog food store, so it's like all natural dog foods and stuff, and so it didn't add up to me. But I see this a lot with vendors that like curve it into something with dogs. And I know that's a good play on words because we do hot dogs, but not the same. So if you're just thinking about your name and you're thinking that way, I'd go a different way. And I'd also not pigeonhole myself. Jason and I talked about this recently, is don't pigeonhole yourself to a type of a name that locks you into a certain menu item, because guaranteed, at some point, you're going to add lemonade, or you're going to add shaved ice, or you're going to do mini donuts or kettle corn, or you're going to start catering. And hey, I know we're called Wolf Street Bistro. We don't have anything to do with the dog food, and we do catering for other foods. Well, it's too late. You've locked yourself into freaking dog food. And so I want you to keep in mind and play with the names and ask people what they think your name sounds like. If you just asked a friend, hey, what does this name sound like? If I say Wolf Street Bistro, what are you going to think? I'm going to think it's like a dog food street food cart. It's all just dog food off of a street cart. That's what I would think. So I want you to play through that with some other people. Also, keep in mind when you're, if you want to be more broad, use something like street food, or I used to say, hey, do always add and catering. But the problem is if it's pizza and catering, well, they're going to think all you cater is pizza. And so I would be something else, because your hot dog cart, your mini mobile food kitchen, does way more than just hot dogs. And so when you're catering with it, you can do so much more. So you just don't want to lock yourself in. I locked myself in the beginning, and so did Jason Brown. Jason Brown made a huge career out of hot dog business, but he locked himself into hot dogs because he was Love Hot Dog Company. Well, he had to change it eventually to Love Food Truck Company. It would have been so much easier had he started that way. We just didn't know better. So maybe we can help you by sharing that information so you don't lock yourself into something that it's hard to. You got to retrain people and make them think, oh, listen, we have nothing to do with dog food. And so you don't want to have to retrain them. You don't want to have to explain it. You want them to be able to see it and know it. I had another short little thing about your name and as you're doing your name, and I can't think of it off the top of my head, but if I think of it, I'll do another video maybe tomorrow and come up with the rest of that. But I would remember those two things. Don't tie it into a dog or a pet or anything. And also don't tie it to hot dogs strictly and only for hot dogs, because then you're kind of keyholing yourself, pigeonholing. Anyway, I love you, and I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye.